Hi, it's Kim from Chatterbox Quilts. Today I'm taking a look at one of the feet that came with the Janome Horizon Memory Craft 9400 QCP Accessory Upgrade Kit, and it is the QZ foot. And this is for variable zigzag stitches. So it's the tiniest of the 4 feet that came with the kit. Just a little tiny guy here. We'll take a closer look at him in a minute. If you haven't already upgraded your own Janome 9400, I have a video that will help you do that. I give you step-by-step instructions on how to go along to upgrade the machine, and I'll put a link in the description below so you can click on that and follow along step-by-step with me to upgrade your Janome 9400. One of the things I wanted to show you is the foot you may have been using before to do variable zigzags, and that is the QZ foot. So it was really nice, it is really nice, because it's got the opening to allow you to do those zigzag stitches, but it's also got the markings on the foot, these red markings that allow you to sort of do some echo quilting around if you wanted to. So you can use it for various reasons. But the only issue I found with this particular foot, I love it when I go around applique to do free motion quilting actually, but what I found is that it sometimes reflects because it's plastic. So when I'm going along and I have the light bouncing off it, it can be a little distracting, a little difficult to see what I'm actually doing. So now with the new foot, the QZ foot, we won't have that issue because it's open. This is the little QZ foot. Remember I told you it was the smallest of them? So it's just a little tiny guy here. And it's open at the front. So you've been able to do variable zigzag stitches before. The nice thing about this foot is it's got all this visibility because it is open. So you'll be able to see the stitches you're creating a little bit easier. Now it needs to be attached to the regular presser foot holder. And you'll notice that it's got two little bars on it. So a little bit different to put on than some of your feet. So you need to hook it on the back of the presser foot bar. There's a little presser foot holder, I should say. There's a little bar that sticks out. You want to hook that underneath the back bar and press down the front just like you do with your other feet. So it'll be on there good and tight. If you want to know more about this particular foot, you can get out your manual. And your manual is going to tell you a little bit of information about it. And if you go to page 2, that's where you'll see that information. So it tells you about the various modes when you can use a variable zigzag and how to work with this foot on the machine. So let's put it on the machine and see how it works. I have my machine set up for free motion quilting. The feed dog's down, I should say. And there is a new screen that's popping up when you upgrade your Janome 9400. When you upgrade the software on your Janome 9400, you'll notice that there are a few new choices on your screen under the sewing application area. That's the t-shirt icon. So we go in there and go to the second page. You'll notice that there's this quilting VZZ and there's RW now. So when you click on that, we're going to be talking about the variable zigzag. The RW is for ruler work, and that's another video. But in the variable zigzag, you'll notice that they've got this little arrow here with the knee lifter, because the knee lifter is what is going to adjust the width of your zigzag stitches back and forth. So let's click on that so we can go into that area. And there are various choices here. The one you want to use with this new foot is either this one or this one. And the only difference in these ones are the needle drop position. So this is going to be in the middle like you're typically used to. This will drop your needle over to the left and you'll hear the needle move over when you do that. I like to use it in the middle position. This just seems more familiar to me. But you've got some other choices here. Now, one thing you'll notice is it's still showing you the QV foot. It doesn't show you the QZ foot here. So it's still showing the other one, but you can certainly use the QZ foot, the new one that you got with this particular choice. You have the zigzag stitches going as wide as possible to 9.0. If you want to, you can make them narrower. So that is the widest it would go. So if you take this down to 8.6, for example, that means that the widest that zigzag stitch would go is 8.6. So that is up to you if you want to limit those choices. And remember that as you stitch along, you're going to be using your knee bar. As you push it out, the stitches get wider. As you let it come back down to normal, they're going to get narrower. So that's what's working when you're using that new QZ foot. So this is sort of like free motion quilting with zigzags. This is great for thread painting, and I'm not an expert in this at all. Make sure you got your presser foot down, and on the screen, if you want your presser foot to come up automatically when you stop stitching, make sure you push that icon on the top to the left. And then we can just see what's going to happen here. Now, how are you going to make these zigzag stitches go wide and narrow and wide and narrow? You're going to use your knee lifter. Okay, so when you push the knee lifter, the farther out you push, you can get right out to that 9 millimeters if you push it all the way out. And then as you gradually come back, you'll notice it comes back and it's a little bit smaller. So let's see how I do with this. So it's just going to do straight stitching until I start engaging that knee lifter. And then as I go narrow with my knee lifter, you have to think about a lot of things here. You got to think about moving your fabric along, making your machine go, and then using the knee lifter. So you can see how that works. And so if I go slow, I'm going to get like a satin stitch almost. If I move my fabric a little faster, it's going to go wider. All right. So you can see what it's doing here. All right, so you can see how you've got the variability in the width of the stitches. And as I said, you can actually limit that if you want. I'm probably going a little slow on this, what I should be doing, but interesting. If you're doing thread painting, I should say, you will like this feature. Certainly takes a bit of practice because you've got several things you have to think about. Even if you set your speed control at what you're comfortable with when you have your foot pedal pressed all the way to the ground, you still have to concentrate on moving the fabric through the machine, and then you've got the knee lifter to think about with your knee. So a few things to think about. It'll take a bit of practice, but certainly you can see what you're stitching out because it's wide open there for you. So I really like that feature with it. So if you're into thread painting, you're going to love this new foot, the QZ foot for your Janome 9400. And if you've liked this video, please give it a thumbs up below and click on subscribe so you'll get notifications the next time we have a new video released. And you can also get free content coming into your email inbox from Chatterbox Quilts. And to do that, you just need to sign up for our email list. So you can go to www.chatterboxquilts.com/free-content. And you may have noticed that the quilt sandwich I'm working with doesn't have any pins in it, and yet I'm not having any issues. It's all staying together. How does it do that? It's because I put it together using the multi-purpose quilt spray. And that's a quilt spray that you can make up yourself with ingredients you probably already have around the house. So if you would like that recipe, it's free. I will put a link in the description below and you can click on that and you can get your own recipe. And that way you can quilt like I do and not have to worry about hitting any pins as you go along.